Abraham Lincoln, Gettysburg Address, and the Emancipation Proclamation. Abraham Lincoln is the well-known and honored 16th President of the United States. He made valuable contributions to our country, and his face is the penny as well as the $5 bill. Lincoln was born February 12, 1809, in Kentucky. His family was very poor and lived in a one-room log cabin. They eventually moved to Indiana. A short time later, when Lincoln was only 9 years old, his mother suddenly died. He was then raised by his sister until his father remarried. Lincoln attended school for only 1 year. He educated himself at home, reading many books that he borrowed from others. His family eventually moved to Illinois, where Lincoln had a variety of jobs, including postmaster, surveyor, and shopkeeper. At age 25, he became an Illinois legislator. A state legislator is someone who makes laws for their state. Lincoln studied law and worked as a lawyer. He later became a member of Congress. Members of Congress help make laws for the entire nation, not just their states. Lincoln ran for senator, but was not elected. A senator is someone who works for the government. Each state in the United States has two senators that represent them. When Lincoln was 33, he married a woman named Mary Todd. They eventually had 4 children together. In 1860, Lincoln ran for president and won the election. He was the tallest president at 6 feet 4 inches. His nickname was Honest Abe. One of the most important things Lincoln is known for is that he wanted to end slavery. He became very well known across the entire country as he argued against it. A slave is a person who becomes the legal property of another person. That's like buying a car and when you become the owner of that car. Back then, it was legal for people to buy other people and become their owners. Slavery began on the continent of Africa. The United States began buying slaves from Africa during the 1600s. People from all 13 colonies owned slaves. Slavery was also practiced in other parts of the world, including Europe. Many people bought African men, women, and children, and then forced them to become their slaves. The black people worked for the white people. Many of them were treated very badly. When the slaves had children of their own, their children automatically became slaves too. Slavery was one of the worst practices in the history of the world. Unfortunately, it continued in the United States during the 1800s, especially in the southern states. Soon after Abraham Lincoln was elected president of the United States, a civil war broke out in America. Slavery was one of the biggest reasons the war had begun. A civil war is when people who live in the same country go to war against each other. 11 southern states decided they no longer wanted to be part of the United States of America. They wanted to keep owning slaves because they depended on them to raise their crops. These 11 states wanted to create a new nation for themselves, where they could own slaves. Instead of the United States of America, they made up a new name for themselves called the Confederate States or the Confederacy. They were angry that Abraham Lincoln and others in the northern states wanted to set all slaves free. So, the northern and the southern states began to fight each other. This war became known as the Civil War. During the Civil War, on September 22, 1862, Abraham Lincoln signed an order called the Emancipation Proclamation. The Emancipation Proclamation ordered 10 of the southern states to free all of their slaves within 100 days. The 10 states were Texas, South Carolina, North Carolina, Georgia, Alabama, Mississippi, Arkansas, Virginia, Kentucky, and Louisiana. But those 10 southern states had already decided they were no longer part of the United States. They were now the Confederacy. This meant that the northern states and the President of the United States had no power over them anymore. The South did not want to free their slaves. In fact, after the Emancipation Proclamation was signed, they only freed about 20,000 out of nearly 4 million slaves. When Lincoln revealed that the South refused to free all their slaves, many people from the northern states joined his armies to fight against the South. During the war, thousands of slaves were set free every day. Many of those slaves who were now free also joined the northern armies to help fight against the South. In addition to the 11 Confederate states, there were 5 other states who also owned slaves, but they were not part of the Confederacy. These states were called border states. They included Kentucky, Missouri, Maryland, Delaware, and West Virginia. Because these states were loyal to the North, they were not required to free their slaves. Tennessee and some areas within Virginia and Louisiana didn't have to free their slaves either. But before the end of the Civil War, some of these states finally ended slavery as well. The Civil War lasted for 4 years. It ended April 9, 1865. Lincoln hoped the country would heal, rebuild, and forgive each other. The Emancipation Proclamation eventually did free millions of slaves, though it was not a law and did not make slavery illegal. However, it led to the passing of the 13th Amendment to the U.S. Constitution on December 6, 1865. That amendment finally made slavery illegal in the United States. Sadly, Abraham Lincoln did not live to see that historical day. He was assassinated or murdered just 8 months before, on April 15, 1865, while attending a play at Ford's Theater in Washington, D.C. The shooter, John Wilkes Booth, was a well-known actor and a Confederate spy from Maryland. Another very important thing that Lincoln is well known for is a speech he gave on November 19, 1863. It is called the Gettysburg Address. Address is another word for speech. Gettysburg, Pennsylvania, was the place where Lincoln gave that speech. He gave this speech during the dedication of a national cemetery. Many of the men who fought for the North during the Civil War were buried in this cemetery. The battle where they died was called the Battle of Gettysburg. People gathered that day to honor the Northern soldiers who had died while fighting to free the slaves. The Battle of Gettysburg had taken place 6 months before Lincoln gave his speech. During this battle, one of the South's most famous generals, named Robert E. Lee, and his troops were beaten by the North. About 3,155 Northern soldiers died during that battle, and more than 14,000 of them were wounded. The Gettysburg Address was only a couple of minutes long, but it has become one of the most famous speeches in history. Lincoln spoke about the importance of freedom and fairness, and that no one is better than anyone else. Lincoln also talked about the past, present, and future of the country. One of the reasons this speech is still popular is because the message is still important for us today. Lincoln spoke about the founding fathers of the United States, like George Washington and Thomas Jefferson. He said they founded the nation for everyone and that all people are created equal. He talked about those who had died on the battlefield at Gettysburg while fighting for the freedom of the country. He told those who were listening that the proper thing to do was to honor the dead and that we should never forget them or their sacrifice. President Lincoln then ended the speech by talking about God and freedom for all people. He said that the government should be for the people and do the will of the people. The full speech is carved into stone on one of the walls of the Lincoln Memorial in Washington, D.C. Abraham Lincoln is still considered one of the greatest U.S. presidents. The state of Illinois is called the Land of Lincoln, and the Lincoln Memorial, the Lincoln Tunnel, and his face on Mount Rushmore have all been named or built in his honor.
Be sure to subscribe.